Cool.
How's everybody? Welcome back to the Tech Reps. I'm Rob. I'm here with my Pisces brother, Homero.
That's right.
I just feel so comfortable when I come here because I've known you for a long time. We did a couple of videos. Homero's with 318. He's going to tell you a little bit about that. But we wanted to, in the last video you saw Homero, and we started to talk about security. And that was a year ago, maybe?
Last summer.
It was last summer?
Last summer, correct.
And you started talking about packets and pockets and jackets and lunch boxes, and I was just like, we have to come back.
And leftovers.
There was the security breach over the summer with the cameras.
Correct.
We've talked a lot about it, and finally I'm back. Homero, give us a little bit about you, and then we'll do some.
Sure. So 318 Technology, we're a small home systems integrator. We do box solutions as well as custom solutions. The custom ones, you know, involve more work. The out-of-the-box solutions are things that we sell that are DIY products that we can very easily put in your home in a day or 2 days, whatever you require.
So when you say a box solution, it's more of the parts that they're familiar with, the name brands they're familiar
Correct.
With, your Sonos.
Your Nest, your Ring doorbell, you know, Control 4 came up with a nice bridge now that we can integrate all these things with. So it's something that it's wireless. Most of the devices are wireless. Very easy to add on to, very easy to keep running the system.
Right. You have packages on the website for that?
I do. You're just gonna click on Small Home in a Box. And you see
cool.
Yeah, we have three packages, and then there's one you can click on that says, you know, custom solution. And then there we'll put the pieces together for you.
Right. I'm pumped up.
Are you?
Because I just came from down the road. I'm gonna go look at the click down there. It's it'll say something about Theo Kalamarakis, and Theo Kalamarakis is the godfather of home theater. We were talking about it when I got in, and I just want to tell Homero on film that we're gonna push you to do Rava home theaters.
Oh wow!
Because I look at it a different way. You know, listen, the home theater, a lot of people, it's not there anymore.
Right.
But I don't think that we're giving the customer the right experience as far as where are your kids at night, where are they during the day. How do you get the family back together in that old 1970s, the way we grew up? It's
Correct.
Time for dinner.
Yep.
Let's watch a movie. So, Rava Home Theater, Theo Kalamarakis, thank you. And I just wanted to give him a shout out. We got the home theater in a box, the custom work you guys do.
Correct.
Control 4 or Savant.
We do Control 4, we do Lutron. Mm-hmm. And to add to what you just said, you know, what we're experiencing is that more often, people only want one home one TV in the home. That is becoming more of the norm, and the one TV isn't the place where everybody goes to watch TV. It's a huge TV, so everyone can actually see, but the other thing that people want is music.
Right.
You know, that's the two big applications for family time.
TV and music.
Correct.
All right, so let's get down to the real deal while we're here, and that's security. And people, every day, we give up security for convenience.
Mm-hmm.
From door locks to the cell phone.
Correct.
And I wanted to come back here and talk to you about security.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't been a victim, but I'm very careless with my passwords, and we talked about different email addresses. And
Correct.
One of the big things I see is the admin.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wanted you to help everyone out there, whether it's another dealer, but more specifically for the homeowners, that what they need to do to protect themselves.
So there's three categories I want to cover. One of them is default settings, poor forwarding, and phishing scams. And with our small home in a box devices, you know, these are things that you buy at, you know, or you can buy at Home Depot or Best Buy. And when they ship, like Rob said, with a password that's the default password, and that's only meant for setup purposes. These passwords should always be changed, and even the username should be changed as well. So if you buy the Nest camera, a Nest thermostat, a Ring doorbell, any of those IoT devices, you know, leaving that default password is the first way you can let a hacker or, you know, someone that wants to mess around with your system get into your system, because, you know, they can figure out the passwords because it's published, it's well known.
Right.
On those devices.
So if I didn't change my passwords, what can happen? Because I always say to myself, oh, what's going to happen? Like, giving out my phone number, what's going to happen?
So if you don't change your password, let's take, you know, as an example, you get a wireless router from Comcast Optimum. It comes with a default username and password that comes from Comcast. And they decide via an algorithm as to what those username and passwords should be. So someone can figure those things out, because that algorithm is generated by some sort of software. So if someone wants to sit in front of your house, you never change the Wi-Fi password on that, you know, router provided by the cable TV company, they can hack your wireless. I mean, and then at that point, They're taking wireless down, they're taking your cameras down, they're taking your thermostats down, they're taking your control system down, and they're taking your whole house down.
Right.
And then that becomes, you know, obviously, how do you fix it? So default passwords, I mean, that is the most extreme. Other things that can happen is if you have port forwarding set up, is if you're forwarding a port from your public IP address to your internal IP address, like as a camera, what happened with the camera hack last year, everyone left their cameras with the default password, and the hackers took your cameras, hijacked them to have an attack on the internet. So that's another extreme. I think people think that, you know, it's never gonna happen to me, but it does, because it has happened. And as more and more of these devices become more and more available, it's attacking the masses, you know. Apple never worried about getting hacked because Apple didn't have the number of phones and computers out there. So now,
that's turned.
Now it's turned, and now everyone wants to hack an Apple computer. So as people put more cameras and, you know, more devices, there is that opportunity. And you know, if you're hacking 10 million Nest thermostats and you get 2%, that's a big number,
right?
That you can still take, you know, to use and do malicious things. So think about it. You know, they can probably get your credit card information, and then they can use that. And you know, everything is pennies and cents and small amounts. No one is going to steal, you know, $1 billion from one user. They want to steal as much as they can, little by little, from different people.
Right. So it goes unnoticeable.
Correct.
One of the other things, I don't know if this is true or not. So you can you break into the house. I guess now we're calling it breaking in network wise. I'll use that term and I'll coin it. Mm. So you break into my network. Is it possible that you steal a little bit of processing from my Nest thermostat, a little bit of processing from this computer, a little bit of processing over here, and then use that processing for whatever you want to do, maybe mine Bitcoins or something?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, that was the old experiment with trying to talk to the aliens. You know, everybody put a piece of software in their computer that allowed the satellites to use that CPU power to actually make it the satellite stronger. I forget what the name of the program was, but that was a long time ago. I don't know if you remember that program. You're gonna have to look it up.
Put a link on the bottom.
but that's exactly it.
Right.
Correct. And that's, you know, that's a safe attack, because they're not necessarily stealing your information. They're using you for their benefit.
Right.
But on the flip side, you know, your cameras may go offline. You may not be able to see your cameras at a time you may need them.
Right.
So, you know, it can always still cause a problem.
So the internet is still so new, and I believe that it's so new that we don't even understand what the repercussions are,
mm-hmm.
right? Especially if you have a young kid at home. My daughter's 12.
Mm-hmm.
I know you have kids at home, and they got their phones.
Correct.
And what I'm getting at is, so the TV here has a camera, right? Mm-hmm. Some of these TVs have cameras on it, your cell phone, all these things have cameras on it.
The computer has a camera, yeah.
And the things we do in our home, we like to keep private.
Correct.
And I talked to some people that will put black tape over there,
mm-hmm.
and this is such a hard topic to discuss because people don't take it seriously. Me in the industry, I don't take it seriously.
Mm-hmm.
And I just want you to touch on those repercussions.
So one of the ways that people take advantage of PCs is by using a phishing scam. So usually what tends to happen is they'll send you an email. It'll be from your buddy, Joe. Hey, click on this link. No, it's a great YouTube. You click on that link, and no YouTube page pops up, but something, you know, the browser opens up something that you don't know what's going on. So what happened is something was stored in the background that the guy that sent you that email now says, hey, I can get access to Bob's computer, and I can see what's going on in his house.
How did they get that information to start with, though?
What, the email?
Yeah.
Oh, email.
How does he make it look like it's coming from...
So I'll give you my experience of what tends to happen here is that on our website, you know, we have an info email. So people tend to use those emails, a lot of public emails that way. And then they'll start just adding people. What your name is, you know, Rob Scuba, Rob.Scuba, Rob, you know, and they'll just, again, you know, they're sending out millions of emails. If 1% of those hit, it's still a lot of people that they've gotten.
Right.
So at that point, you know, they'll do one or two things. They'll be able to use your computer for bad things, or they'll be able to use your computer to then call you and say, or give you an ad that says, your computer's infected, please call this phone number. And then when you call that phone number, they're gonna want hundreds of dollars so that they can get that ad off of your computer.
Mm-hmm.
So that is, you know, phishing scams are the way that, really the easiest way for things to get hacked. It happened to Hillary Clinton, or you know, one of her people on her campaign.
Right. What's the easiest way when we get an email to know or to try and guard? Is there any way to see it in that email?
So there really isn't. But there may be typos. The email may be very short. There may not be a signature. Sometimes I've gotten emails from, let's say, Optimum, that if you look at the actual email it's coming from, it says, you know, something that's not optimum.net.
Right.
You know, if it's like Citibank emailing you, just call Citibank.
Right.
Hey, why am I getting this email? And they'll tell you, no, it's a hoax, it's not a whatever it is. But anything that's financial, asking for account information and billing information, you know, your account is passed through, most of those companies will not email you. They'll call you or they'll send you a letter in the mail.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're responding to those emails, you click on that link, you've made a mistake.
Okay, so now I did the email, I sent it back out.
Mm-hmm.
Now I get this screen that says, you're infected, call me.
You call them.
Right.
You have to.
You have to call them.
Yeah, I mean, the only other option you have is to rebuild your computer, most likely. Most likely they've already hijacked your computer at that point. It's almost impossible for you to gain access back to it.
I can't take it to Best Buy.
And have them reformat it.
Reformat it. Lost everything on the computer. Lost everything.
Data's gone.
My pictures.
Yeah.
My...
Hopefully you put it in Dropbox or Google Drive or something, otherwise it's gone.
Alright, so give them some tips. You just gave a tip there.
So,
back up the computer?
Back up the computer. So, I mean, well, at home, you know, we use Google Drive because Google Drive gives you a certain amount of data for no cost. You know, we're also Android users for our phones, so we back up all of our phones. Having multiple places of backup, which phones, computers, Google Drives is good because, you know, if one device gets lost or stolen or hacked, you have those other devices to go to.
Right.
Dropbox, Microsoft Office does it, same thing. There's a lot of them out there for free, and you know, some of them you may have to pay for, depends on how much data you have.
I didn't know that. I figured I could just take my laptop to Best Buy and have them fix the virus, but you're not saying that. I'm gonna have to pay the money to
most
get
likely.
My business back.
Correct.
And then I'm going to be smart enough to back it up. I'll have you guys come in and service my stuff. I mean,
correct.
Do you guys have a service that you...
So we don't actually offer a service to clean computers. You know, it's...
Not clean it, but would you go to a customer and say, this is, we're going to set your house up.
So
we're going to do the default settings.
So,
we're going to change that.
So what we do offer our customers is a network assessment. So if you feel that, hey, I'm adding a lot of IoT devices, my internet is slow, I want to know what's going on, we'll go out there with a laptop, scan what's going on in the network, get all of the devices that are on the network, see what the manufacturer is, you know, what type of device it is, and give you a report and say, hey, this is what you have on your network. Do you know these three iPhones? You know, you told me you only have 10, but you know, it shows 20 iPhones on your network. Whose devices are these? Yeah.
But now, if my neighbor comes over, he gets my password and my daughter and all these,
mm-hmm.
So they're gonna come on there, but they won't be live.
So the one thing to recommend for that is to always have a guest network.
A guest network.
Yeah.
Is that come standard a cable router, or are we gonna have to buy it?
So some routers do have them standard, but most people don't configure it because they don't know about it.
Right. But you can come over there, you can configure, give me a guest
correct.
Network on my cable router that
yes.
I don't have to pay more money.
Correct. Correct.
All right. I'm gonna keep coming back here. Just to review real quick, default settings.
Change them.
That's on my cable router.
Username and passwords. Any device. Nest camera, Nest thermostat, Ring doorbell. Any IoT device. Change the username and password.
And the main router, which is your cable router.
Correct.
Second one, port forwarding.
If you have to forward a port, make sure you change the default settings.
Again, that's a separate device. We're not talking about the cable box. Now we're going to port forward to a camera.
Correct.
My router has a different name, username, and password than the admin.
Correct.
And the camera now has a different password.
Correct.
Third one, phishing scams.
Don't click on an email if you're not sure what it's about. And you know, if it's a financial email, you know, always call the bank, always call the people sending you that the email saying that you owe them money.
Right.
You know, they'd rather hear from you on the phone, because if you owe them money, they can get it from you right then and there. Over an email, never make a transaction.
Good. Correct. Listen. I can never spend enough time here, and I'm never going to learn myself, and the time I call you, it's going to say, Romero, you're not going to believe what just happened.
You got hacked.
And you'd be like, I do, because you got hacked.
Because you're an iPhone guy.
Tell them where you're at, brother.
So our website's 318 Technology. We're in Tarrytown, New York, 505 White Plains Road, Suite 124. We have a whole working system here. If you ever want to come visit us anytime, just call us, email us, we're more than happy to have you come over.
I hope you guys like these videos. I think this is one of the more important ones. Usually it falls on deaf ears. I come to Homero because this is what he does. He started in a networking arena, I'll say, and then you came into the home theater.
Correct.
If you're using just a regular home theater guy or just the guy down the block, I recommend getting a professional that has a networking background. And I would give Homero a call. You can reach out to us. It's Rob at thetechreps.com, www.techreps.com, at thetechreps on all social media platforms. Where are you on social media?
I'm on Instagram and Facebook, 318 Technologies. We're easy to find. If you want to email us, just email us at info@318technology.com, and we'll get back to you.
Valentine's Day is coming up. Come click on Smart Home in a Box.
That's right.
We talked about this.
No candy this year.
You know, all you ladies out there that are suspicious of your man, I want you to get a Ring doorbell, okay? We'll tell you what the password username is after Homero installs it, and you'll know exactly who's walking in and out of his house, all right? That's a good tip. All right, you had one more tip, didn't you?
You can actually just get a Nest camera for indoor. There's apparently a watch you can put in front of it, a clock now. Whatever.
If you're in that kind of relationship, you need to get out anyway.
Yeah, exactly.
So, but it's cheaper to get the ring and find out what's going on than it is to buy it and then get engaged, right?
You're right.
All right, brother. Homero, thank you so much.
Thank you, Rob.
All right, we'll see you soon.
You got it, brother.
Thanks, guys. Ciao.